If you want to stay updated about our channel, then please subscribe and hit that bell. Please enjoy the video. For the dive equipment setup, start by inspecting the scuba tank and check all the numbers on the tank. Especially check the hydrostatic test date and check your visual inspection, making sure that all the dates are correct. Check if the O-ring is in there and that it is in great condition. Then check the tank valve which way is open and closed, and give it a little burst to clean the valve. Once that's okay, grab your BCD at the BCD handle. Put your safety strap away and then correctly place the BCD over your scuba tank. Make sure that it's at least 4 fingers from the top, and then close the buckle. Double check if everything is attached. Make sure that the tank valve is parallel with the BCD handle. Place on the safety strap and tighten the safety strap accordingly. Again, double check your BCD handle that it's parallel to your tank valve. You can also check if the tank is not too high or too low by placing your hand and fingers at the top of your valve and your BCD. Now, to make sure that everything is attached correctly, grab your BCD tank or the handle of your BCD and then give it a little wiggle. Just make sure you be careful of your back. Grab your regulator, unscrew the dust cap from the first stage. Make sure that the two breathing hoses are on the right side of the right shoulder of your BCD. Place the first stage over the valve and then gently screw until it's closed. Now, it's very important, do not do this too tight. So only 3 fingers tight. It's all okay if your first stage moves a little bit before we open up the tank. Then attach the low pressure inflator hose by pulling back the top of your low pressure inflator hose and connecting it to your inflator hose of the BCD. Make sure afterwards you streamline it. Once it's all streamlined, looks in order, grab your alternate air source and attach your alternate air source at the right spot of your BCD. Make sure the yellow is shining outwards. Now, if everything looks good, before we open up the tank, turn your SPG away from you, so the glass, in the unlikely event, if it damages, it cannot hurt anybody. Hold down the inflator bottom of the BCD and then slowly open up the tank, instantly releasing the inflator button of the BCD. All the way open up the tank until the end. Now, do a full check of your dive equipment by fully inflating the BCD first until air escapes from the BCD, and then wait a second. Make sure there's no leaks. Squeeze it a little bit. So now we check that air actually goes in and that there's no leaks. Then deflate the BCD by releasing all the air. Then check if it also works orally. By putting a bit of air in there, a couple of breaths is enough. Make sure you press down the deflator button when you breathe in. Once that's all okay, then deflate the BCD again. Then grab your second stage in your right hand and your SPG in your left hand. Clean your second stage by perching a little bit, then smelling it, making sure that the air is not contaminated. And then put your second stage in your mouth and breathe in slowly and deeply a few times while looking at your air gauge. Your air gauge needle should stay still. If it moves, then there is a problem. If it is all okay, then put your second stage down again, take out your alternate air source, and repeat the process. Gently breathe in and out, making sure that everything is okay. Replace the alternate air source and make sure that everything is streamlined again. Then, after it's all good and streamlined, gently place your equipment on its side, make a nice little package out of it. As compact as possible. Now, when it all looks good and done, you can walk away. For the buoyancy check on the surface, communicate to your body that you're about to perform the buoyancy check. Put your second stage into your mouth. Then deflate your BCD while holding a normal breath. You should sink down, but be neutrally buoyant at around eye level. If that's the case, then you're properly weighted for the dive. Then, after you perform the scale, fully inflate your BCD again. To perform the PADI diver toe, first communicate with your body. Ask him if he's okay and ask him to fully inflate the BCD to make sure it's positively buoyant. Make sure that everybody has the mask on and regulator in. Grab your body's tank valve and then slowly start to swim. Make sure you communicate once in a while throughout the swim and ask if your body is still okay. Keep looking behind you once in a while so you don't accidentally swim into anything. And keep pulling your body. Keep looking, keep swimming, and keep communicating once in a while. The swim is for 25 meters. So slowly turn your body around. Again, keep communicating and keep swimming to the confined water until you finish the 25 meters. First, start by having your mask on and your snorkel in. Make sure your BCD is fully inflated. Then, undo your chest strap. Unclip your belly buckle off your BCD and remove the Velcro strap. Stay on your back, release your shoulder straps, and then gently take off your BCD. Make sure you keep holding on to your BCD. Especially if you have a weight belt on. To go back in, open up your BCD, make sure that everything is clear, nothing is entangled, and once you're ready, go back into your BCD. The easiest way of doing it is to lay or sit on top of your BCD. Make sure you don't turn your body so it doesn't fall off. Put your arms through your BCD. Then close your BCD by using the Velcro strap. Reconnect the belly buckle of your BCD. Stay on your back. Pull down your shoulder straps until it's nice and snug. And do not forget to reconnect your chest strap. Remember, take your time, do it nice and slow. If you can't find it, no problem. Make sure that everything is streamlined. Double check that nothing is entangled. Sure, you replace your SPG. Make sure that all that air source is under the arm, yellow shining outwards. Again, everything looks good and in order. And then you're done. First, start by signaling that you're ready to go down. Look around you to orientate yourself. Look down below you to make sure that everything is clear under you. Then, on step number 3, switch over from your snorkel to your regulator and clear your regulator from any water. Step 4, check your dive computer or dive watch. Then, on 5, equalize, elevate and deflate your BCD while exhaling slowly. Keep contact with your body at all times. When you slowly descend, make sure you keep equalizing your ears. Make sure you look down, that you don't touch anything below you. Stay close to your body and equalize accordingly. Keep communicating to your body and equalize your ears, slowly descending. Once you reach the bottom, make sure you add a little bit of air in the BCD to become neutrally buoyant, get in the right trim position. Most importantly, do not touch that bottom. Once you're okay, communicate to your body that you are okay to continue your dive. First, you recognize that there is a problem with your body's cylinder tank strap. Clearly communicate to your body that something is wrong with the connection of your scuba cylinder tank strap and that you will reconnect it. Ask your body to wait patiently. Then swim behind your body. Turn the tank, readjust, make sure that the tank valve is parallel to the BCD and that there's at least 4 fingers from the top. You can use your knee to easily readjust your tank whenever it's needed. When it's okay, reconnect the cylinder strap. Double check if everything is straight, everything is streamlined, and that the connection is steady. Once everything is perfectly back into place, communicate with your body again that everything is okay, body up, and continue your dive. For the next skill, swimming over sensitive bottom, it is important that you are in a perfect trim and making sure that you're completely streamlined with your equipment. You can put your arms in front of you and have them close together. To swim around, you can use the scissor kick or the frog kick. We would recommend the frog kick if you can. Throughout the swim, make sure that you check that you don't touch the bottom accidentally, don't touch the surface, and keep checking if your equipment is still streamlined. Keep swimming nicely and slowly. Keep swimming around the pool. At any times, if you're moving from the shallow end to the deep end, just make sure you deflate your BCD a little bit, exhale slowly, and equalize your ears as often as possible. Again, once you reach the bottom of the deep end, make sure you don't touch the bottom and stay streamlined. First, take a deep breath in, take out your second stage, mouthpiece down, blow bubbles and gently put some air into your BCD by pressing the deflator button while you blow in. Then go back to your second stage, clear it either way you like it, take a nice gentle breath in and see if you start to rise. Once you start rising, Make sure that you streamline yourself. Do not kick and scull. So keeping your legs together. Also keep your arms together. Then, by breathing in and out normally, you should stay in one place. Keep breathing. Don't hold your breath. Keep checking once in a while that you stay in one place and that you're not accidentally touching the bottom or the surface. Keep doing this for at least 1 minute. If you want to do it in a different position, like I'm showing right now in the video, that is absolutely no problem. You can do this in any position you prefer. You can always adjust the BCD by letting some air out or putting some more in, but if you do that, you have to do it orally again. After a minute, completely deflate your BCD, and then the skill, orally inflate your BCD and hover for at least 1 minute, is done. First of all, move your head to the right. Then, remove the mouthpiece from your second stage out of your mouth, but only do this halfway. Have your mouthpiece on the outside of your left cheek, then gently start purging the second stage to simulate a free flow. While the free flow is happening, breathe in and out slowly. It's actually very easy to breathe to a reflowing regulator, so don't panic at all. Breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Keep breathing for at least 30 seconds. In and out, and in and out. After 30 seconds, replace the second stage into your mouth. Clear it by exhaling or any way you like it. If you have some water in your mask, just clear your mask like you practiced before. Begin by taking off your mask in neutral buoyancy. Remember to hold onto the mask and then gently start swimming forward. You can use your hand to guide yourself along the bottom, making sure you go the right direction. Make sure you're neutrally buoyant though, and you just swim and only use your hand to guide you. Remember, don't drop your mask. If you feel comfortable without using your hand to guide you, you can just do it fully in neutrally buoyancy. Remember to keep holding onto the mask and swim for at least 15 meters. Put the mask back on, first making sure that the nose bucket is down again, snorkel on the side, hair out of the way, put the mask on first, and then the strap. Sure the strap is not twisted again and that it's high above your ears. When everything is in order, with two fingers, touch the top frame of your mask and then breathe into your mouth and out through your nose while looking up, until all the water is cleared from your mask. Whenever you're ready, make contact with your body. Grab your air gauge, tap on your air gauge to ask the air of your body. Your body will give the amount of air. Make sure you're okay to it, that you understand that person. And now the body will ask you. Give him your amount of air and make sure that your body gives you an okay so you understand. Then continue the dive. So the first thing for the 5-point ascent is to signal to your body that you're okay to go up. Then the next step is to check the ending dive time. Then for step 3, go into the right ascent position by moving your right hand above your head to protect your head and your left hand on the deflator button. Step 4, check if everything is clear above you. And on step 5, we're slowly going to swim up to the surface, rotating your body making sure that everything is clear above you, and keep an eye on your body so you stay close. Do not swim faster than 18 meters per minute. Once we reach the surface, then keep your mask on your face. Keep your regulator second stage in, fully inflate until air escapes from your BCD, and then switch from your regulator second stage to your snorkel. And now you've completed the skill. Start by deflating your BCD, and while you're deflating your BCD, effectively kick so your face stays above the water. Then with your right hand, take off your weight belt and drop it right next to you. Then, while you're now positively buoyant, lean backwards to end the skill. Start by closing off your scuba tank completely. Turn off the air all the way. Once it's turned off, take out your alternate air source, hold it with your right hand, and then your second stage in your left hand. Perch at exactly the same time, both second stages, until all the air is released from the hoses and the first stage. Gently put it on the floor. Unstreamline your LPI hose and disconnect it by pulling back the top of the LPI and gently disconnect it. Then, gently unscrew your first stage from the tank valve. And then, very important, remember to dry that dust cap from any water, so no water can enter your first stage. We recommend using a dry cloth or towel for this one. Once it's okay, place back the dust cap on the first stage. Double check everything from any leaks, and once that's okay, you can use what we call a spaghetti loop technique to make a nice little loop out of your regulator system and then gently put it on the floor. Then, release your safety strap, take it off the tank valve, then hold on to the BCD with one hand, release the tank strap, and remove the BCD from the tank cylinder. Gently put it on the floor again, and make a nice little package out of it. Then grab the tank and very gently put it on its side on the floor so it can't fall over anymore. Put your BCD and the regulator together. Double check if everything is streamlined. And then you can walk away.